And then lastly, I will do a quick scroll through all my couponing apps. Now, usually Shopkick doesn't change their offers too often. Usually what I'll do is I'll hop into Fetch and I'll sort my deals to most recent. So I have most recent. So I'll just go in here real quick. I'll see, hey, is there anything new? No, these are old, so I don't have to waste time scrolling through all of that. I'll hop into Field Agent and I'll see if there's any deals in my area. I'll hit refresh here real quick. I'll say, oh no, there's nothing new in here. Now, just a side note, if you're not familiar with any of the apps I've mentioned throughout the video, I do have walkthrough beginner videos on all of these. So if you want to learn more about them, definitely check those out. But anyways, like I'll go back into coupons.com and I will sort by newest. I'll see if there's anything new that I might want to add to my list. And I do recommend adding anything you're vaguely interested in because they can pull these at any time. But if you've actually clicked the plus, and this applies to most apps like Checkout 51, the Ibotta app, the coupons.com app, if you see anything you're interested in, add it. It's more likely to disappear if you didn't add it to your account, but if you add it, you have a higher chance of it sticking around longer. So say like this Airwick one, this doesn't expire until 8/6/21. Now I'll add it, and if I add it, it's guaranteed to stay on my account until 8/6/21. But I have seen these disappear before the expiration date if you did not click the plus. I think there is a certain limit of how many people can redeem these, but if you do add it to your account, they usually honor that and it will stick around. So I'll just go through all my apps, and pretty much any app like MyPoints, Ibotta, you can almost always sort these newest to oldest, so you don't have to scroll through the whole app and waste an hour going through everything. And make sure you're hitting by recent, and just look real quick if you see stuff you don't recognize, and if it's the same thing you've been looking at all week, don't waste your time going through the entire app. Then for Ibotta, and that's my main app that I use for pretty much everything, I will go ahead and I'll go into earn more. I'll see if I have any bonuses going on that are worth chasing. So say like I have a buck off 15 offers, that's not real good, so I probably won't chase that. But like I said earlier, Walmart is my main store, so I'll just hop in here before I go shopping and I'll hit new offers. This will show me anything new they added, so I'll just scroll through here, see if there's anything new that might match up with something else I saw earlier in the day. Like here we have a freebie, so I'll add that. Now, I know it may seem kind of overwhelming when you're first starting out, but once you've been doing this for a while, when you find matchups, they'll kind of jump out at you. You'll just kind of have an idea of what coupons you have in your binder or what's on sale. Say like, let's see here, I might have seen someone talking earlier in the day about Alba Botanica on Instagram, and then I'll hop on Ibotta and go, oh, I have a rebate on there, and you can combine them. That's usually how I happen upon matchups. I'm just scrolling through stuff and happen to find stuff that matches up when we have deals on the same brand on multiple apps. They kind of, after a while, once you've been navigating these apps, the matchups just kind of jump out at you, or just if you are watching YouTube videos and seeing the different brands and different offers that other people are doing, they kind of just jump out at you. But the reason I like following everyone on like Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, it takes out all that legwork. So instead of me slowly going through Ibotta, I mean, we have like 15 categories in here. I'm pretty sure we have over 150 rebates, because you can sit here scrolling for an hour, and that's just to get for one store. It just saves a lot of time to take advantage of these other couponers who are doing all this hard work. So as I said before, I'll put links to everyone that I follow that I'd like to recommend to you guys to follow as well. And I'll also put a link to a blank version of the Google Drive sheet that I use to put together my hauls. But let me know if you have any questions, and if you want to learn more in depth about any of the couponing apps I've mentioned throughout this video, check out my beginner's playlist. I have long walkthroughs where I explain the app and I basically press at any button you could think of.